My six concrete tips for operators at this moment. One, don't freeze memberships, but extend them. If this lasts for 1, 2, 3, 4 months, if you freeze the contributions, then you don't have any revenues, you don't have income. Let's say one average club needs 80,000 euro, so let's say more or less $100,000 a month to survive. Lose that, overall, they have to close the gym then. So immediately what I said to the people, okay, don't, let's not freeze it, but let's communicate with our members. Can you help us? Can you please stay a member from us? And please hold the payments. And then we ask you, okay, if this crisis lasts 2 months or 3 months, can be extended to February, March, and April. And we had in this case with 1,600 members, we had only 30 people said, now we're not going to be a member anymore. But that means that 1,570 people are still paying their contribution. Of course, at the end, I have to extend it, so I have to solve it, but it's still, I can solve it during a period of a year or something like this. And I keep paying my bills, I can pay my staff, and I can everything cover my costs. Number two, ask your employees to help with the solutions. And the government says, okay, if you will keep the staff at work, we will pay you maximum between 60 and 190% of your staff cost if you don't fire them. We said to our employees, okay, we have 1, 2, 3 weeks now. We can do extra maintenance. We can do extra cleaning. But after that, you have to wait 6, 7, 8, perhaps two or three months at home. We will pay you 100%. But in our case, we will only get 80% of the cost. 80% from the government. So if we have a good relationship with our employees, we ask them one by one in every club, we ask them, okay, but we are paying you, for instance, 20 hours a week. You can stay at home for 20 hours a week, but we only get 16 hours of you paid. I ask every employee, would you help us with the 4 hours, which we don't get subsidized from the government, would you do that for free on a voluntarily basis? Besides one person, all employees said, perfect, of course we're going to do that. We help you. The most important, of course, is their managers and their coordination and the manager from the fitness exercise and the manager on the spot, on the location. They really have a very good relationship with their staff. They can help us. Sometimes when they need some extra motivation about the business point of view, I can help them with that. But I've got great managers. Number three, stop paying the rent for your landlord. Of course you do it on a decent way, but you go to your landlord, I cannot use the facility as what I was going to rent for. I'm supposed to rent a fitness club and I cannot use it for a fitness club. So help me again, don't push it too hard. But at the end, if you have to do it, this is the most important. Of course you do it on the normal way. You try to have a relationship with your landlord. But at this moment, I have to find priorities. And the priority is paying the bills, paying my staff, look, survive at this moment. If I say to a landlord, I miss really 80,000 euro every month at this moment. I don't have zero income. Could you help me? They will help you. And perhaps he wants to, okay, if I have a contract for 5 years still at this moment, okay, said, okay, put 3 months or half a year extra or at the end of the contract, extend the contract. Number four, start social community and communicate. We try to build up a relationship because we know our clients. And when they don't arrive in a fortnight, in 2 weeks, we already call them. Hey, what's going on? When are you coming back? And these kind of things. So that means we have a very close contact. And you have, okay, what do we get for it? We don't pay. But you, okay, first of all, you help us survive. We can reopen again if you help us. It's not a problem to put that business point on an emotional level to them. You have to share your problem. We have a big problem now. And if you stay a member, we can be open again. What can we do? Every day we start the social communities. Every day we have workouts. It's from spinning to yoga to Pilates classes, everything. And that helps a lot. So it's a combination. It's the business. You can share your problem, but you have to show them also, okay, what can we do for you? And every week we communicate. It's communication. Communicate, communicate, communicate. Don't be shy to share your problem. Don't be too proud also to share your problem. Why not? Why can't you say to your members, we really have a problem and we need you to help to solve this? And some people always have problems with the ego. And then I found a sentence, when the ego cries, the soul rejoices. And I like that sentence. Don't be too proud to ask for help me, please. Help us. Number five, don't invent the wheel. But I always say the most important is what I learned, especially with URSA, is don't invent the wheel. Copy from each other. Look around to other operators. Okay, what are you doing? What are you doing with this thing? And how can you evolve that to something that's going on? If you see nice newsletters from other people, from other companies, use that. Start with that. Don't invent the wheel. Stay calm and share your information. And number six, cut your cost. Yeah, that is so obvious, of course, but I still wanted to say it. Cut your costs at this moment. Cut your costs and be creative. In my biggest club, I'm paying almost 10,000 a month, almost with a swimming pool, for energy costs. So the manager went to the energy company and said, okay, can we cut it for 50% at this moment? We're not using it. And even more, so it's small things, but I suggested, like the music rights. We don't have music in our gyms at this moment. This helps you 500, 600, 700, 800 euro per month. It's perhaps, and all these things together will help you.